as I've always been told by a former coach of mine, Pat Riley, championships are won on the road. I think the pressure now switches to them more so than us, because they have to try to close us out on Sunday. So we're going to go there, and we're going to give them a good fight and try to get this team back to Atlanta on Tuesday.
How are you doing, Elijah? Average Sporting Biz. Do you see a weakness in their gameplay for the next game that you think you can expose?
Not really. I thought we did a lot of good things on our end. Defensively, there's some adjustments that we'll probably have to make. But again, you got to get advantage to a big hand. That was a big shot she hit at the end. Could have missed it, but she didn't. So, no, we were right there all the way to the end. And again, there's some things that we didn't do offensively that I felt we're going to do a lot better to give us a better chance to win.
I hear Michael Cole.
Can you go into those things that you need to do better offensively? And can you describe what the final play was supposed to be, the one that McCutcheon had to put up a three-pointer?
No, those will be secrets. You just have to watch the game. It makes for an intriguing next game for us. But I think there's some things defensively that we want to do better. I saw some things where we can get Erica some more shots. I think that would help. But the last play was supposed to be a split play. And again, we just kind of like botched the play in a sense. And again, she still got a good look at that shot. So I give her that one any other time.
Don Stenson with DNA Sports. Coach, Della Don had 21 points at the end of the third quarter and finished with 21 points. What type of defense did you change up to?
Just a smaller player. Took Sancho off of her and put Angel. Angel obviously knows how to play a little bit better. And again, she's more of a perimeter player than she is a big that likes to score. She wants to shoot jump shots, and I thought that worked for our advantage.
Coach, Amir Shaw, could you talk about the defense on the last half of Vandersloot shot? Was there a switch? What happened that last?
Well, it's supposed to be. They run a lot of pick and rolls. And again, one of the things that for our guard, especially Shoney, who has a hard time picking rolls, I mean, that's one of our weaknesses that they really try to capitalize on. And again, they just ran a pick and roll, but she got through the first one, and then the second one was so low. Again, there's times in the game where you have to do basketball things, and I think the basketball thing was for Erica to switch. But that's kind of spilled milk. It's over with, and we'll get better. And again, those are some of the things we will work on for the next game.
James Bowman, Swish Appeal. Talk about Angel's game. She played a lot of roles in this game. Defended Elena Del Dunn, had 9 points in the fourth quarter, almost carried the dream over the top. How do you feel about her game today?
Well, I feel great. Angel's competitive. She's going to come out and compete every single game. That's the one thing I know about her that she's going to do, as well as our team. And she's a leader in the ball club. And again, she tried to will this win for us. But again, that goes to show you that basketball is not a one or two or three player sport. It takes 5 players for you to be successful to win a game and a championship. And we were real close. But again, she did some things that I saw against the defense that I think we'll be able to capitalize on the next game, too.
Coach, over here. Terry Schwartz, I'm back in the world. I wanted to know, towards the end of the first half, you had a 12-point lead. Either one of you can answer this. What exactly do you think happened there? I thought that changed the entire complexion of the
game. We got complacent a little bit. Started, you know, when you get into the playoffs, regular season and playoffs are two different types of seasons. And in the playoffs, you just can't. Shot selection and value of the basketball are important. And I thought we got caught up into that game where we took about 2 or 3 quick shots. They went down and scored. And that can hurt you in a sense, which I thought it did too, because instead of going up 12-14, it came down, I believe, to 6 or something like that. So whatever. But shot selection was big for me. What did you see, Sancho?
The same thing we saw. We shot a few really bad shots, and they ran back in offense without the heels to the ground. So we got some easy buckets, some easy threes, and they were back in the game.
Coach, I think you opened at one point in the second quarter a 12-point lead, and you actually held the Sky to 5 points up until maybe 2:40 left in the quarter, and then the bottom fell out. They went on a 13-2 run. Can you account for exactly what happened? Did they pick it up, or did your team kind of lack off?
Going to half being down by 12, and it came down, they hit 2 threes, they had a couple steals, and they, you know, the other guy had 2 layups, and they were back in the game. It, I think think it's nothing that we didn't do, it's just what they wanted to do.
Sancho, how do you feel about tonight's performance, and what is your response for the next game?
For me, I just gotta make shots. In my heart, I think if I made more shots, the outcome of this game wouldn't have been this way, because the amount of shots that I missed tonight could have been the amount of points on the board. But as I said to myself, and coach just told me, there's another game, and I gotta let this one go, because if I take it into another game, it'd be the same outcome.
Terry French from Dev Talk Radio. You did mention that Chicago, it would be a pressure on them going back to Chicago, but you guys were 6-11 on the road. There's anything, and it's true that it's different from the regular season to the postseason. What would you do different on the road going into Chicago on Sunday?
I think there's a little bit more togetherness, and I think at home, when you're home, there's a lot of distractions around you. So when we go out on the road, it'll be just us working together. And I think that close knitness will help us in that. But again, I think rebounding is going to be definitely important on the road. Right now, they're holding the rebounding edge, getting all the 50-50 balls, and I think that's important. So in order for us to stay in that game on Sunday, we're going to have to get those 50-50 balls, hold our own on the boards, and again, do the things we're supposed to do offensively.
Coach, Chastity on Sports Talk Radio. Scott had 3 fast break points, you guys had 2, but we all know Atlanta Dream likes to get in the open court and run. Are you going to try to make a conscious effort or make some adjustments to try to do that?
We want to run. You know, we tell Celine, go, go, go every time. And if she'll run it down, then she'll pull it back out. And that's not, again, the tempo that we want to play at. We want to get the ball down the court. Let's play a little bit, move the ball around, make them have to deal with whatever we're doing. And then if it's not there, now you have time to set up the offense. So, yeah, we'll be definitely looking to change the pace of the game, because I thought 80% of this game was played at Chicago's pace.
Speaking of rebounding, Sancho, you did a very good job on the boards, especially on the defensive boards. Is there something that you can do or you want to do in the next game to add on to your offensive rebounding?
Offensive rebound is more 50-50. Defensive rebound, well, it's more will, because we need the ball. I just gotta pick my spots. I can't run up inside there for offensive rebound and then it's going the other way. I gotta read the game and see how it goes. If that is what I need to do next game, then I have to do it.
Coach, as a person, do you think there was at one point it was a little bit of one-on-one or one-on-three, a little bit too much of not moving the ball around?
No, I think that's the way we play the initial first part of our offense. We want to go down and play. Just play a little bit of basketball, let them improvise, use their athletic skills and make things happen for us, which I thought Angel did extremely well. We wanted to use more of our driving kick game, which I didn't think we did well, because once you drive in there and there's 2 defenders, you got to kick the ball out. So, but no, that doesn't bother me, because again, that's why we're here, is the way that we're playing. We just need to be a little bit more fundamentally sound, both offensively and defensively, going down the stretch, and have a little bit more tenacity at getting after the boards.
Over the years, the Atlanta Dream, and Sancho, I know you can attest to this, has had a fierce running game. You have a little bit of a running game tonight, but not as much as the Dream are accustomed to. Is that something that you want to instill back in the players, or is it something that you've taken out to put something else in?
We have a different point guard. You know, she sees us a little differently. We are told to run first and pull it out after. But as I say, I'm not the point guard. I can't see it. I just pass the ball and I go to my spots. If coach sees something different, he'll tell us. If not, and we run the place.
But you know, again, just to add to that answer, is that that's the beauty of basketball, man. That's the beauty of playoff basketball. It's a chess match. And yeah, we want to get out and run. I think our transition game was just as fierce this year as it was last year. But good teams do a good job of combating that. And how they did it was they get to the boards. They get to the offensive boards, and you score points, and it's hard to run when you're taking the ball out of bounds. So again, it's not. I don't think it's anything we're not doing. It's what the other teams are trying to do to prevent that, because they know if we get into that running game, that's problems for them.
Any other questions?
We want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. We really appreciate your attendance, and we want you to know that we'll be back here on Tuesday, and I hope we see all your faces here. Thank you.